Hey girl, welcome back to another weekly vlog. Okay, so we're currently outside of Five Below because I'm looking for like little miscellaneous things to put inside of the boys' Valentine's Day basket. I got the majority of their stuff off of Amazon, so when that comes in, I'm gonna show you guys, and of course we're gonna build the basket together. But I just left Marshall's. They were not giving what they were supposed to give. I really wanted to stay on the Valentine's Day theme, but Marshall's, they weren't delivering at all. But still, I just got him like some basic PJs. It's a two-piece set, so two pairs of shirts and then the pants to go along. And then I just got him a Nike set, like for the summer when it starts to get cold. I got 24 months. I felt like it was better for me to size up so he can wear them longer than for me to stay at 18 and he grows out of them like a weed. Because that boy, I think he'd be growing in his sleep or something, because the clothes, like the 18 month clothing that he has now, like they're starting to fit him a little snug. And I don't like that. I really don't. I'd be looking at his clothes, especially when I'm out shopping for him. I'd be looking at the 24 months and I'm like, wow, is my baby really this big? Like, yes, Naomi, he really is. Stop talking yourself out of it. Hello. I just got my boyfriend a soap. He's a sucker for natural soap, so I felt like it would be like a good basket stuffer. My voice cracks. Sorry, not sorry. But we're outside of Five Below. I feel like they would be more on brand, like with the Valentine's Day. Hopefully they don't disappoint me. So let's just go ahead and go in, girl.
We are doing so much better in here already. I got this for my boyfriend because he loves Sour Patches. Got this for Kay. How cute. It says, "You're my dumpling." And this is not a part of the basket, but I got hand soap because we needed some. Super off topic, but this is so cute.
Hey girl, happy Wednesday. Also, happy Valentine's Day. I'm currently on my lunch break. I am sitting outside of this place. It's called Zoop. I decided to treat myself today for lunch. Okay, I'm sick and I really wanted a soup. So we are outside. It's giving like a Panera, but soupy. I don't know, but my coworkers put me on and they did their thing with this one because the soup is so good. We're all sick in our household, so I've been feeling like a pile of wet poop. So I figured a little soupy soup would make me feel a little better. Also, we have to stop by Dollar Tree today, either after I finish eating here or after work, because I still have to get baskets and like those little confetti things that go inside them for the boys' Valentine's Day basket. Yes, I'm very much last minute. Will I ever change? I don't know. Stay tuned, because for now, we are very last minute. Let's go and eat some a soupy soup at a Zoop. Y'all, my head freaking hurts, and I don't know if it's because of this cold that my toddler infected me with, or if it's because like my bun is too tight. Almost lost my camera. Love that for me. And I keep dripping snot, like I hate this. So if you're not ready to be sick 24/7, don't get pregnant. Don't be a mom, because you'll be having tissue stuck in your nose like this for the foreseeable forever. Anyways, I just got off of work and we're about to hit up Dollar Tree really quick before we have to go pick up Kay. So let's go ahead and do that very quickly. This
Dollar Tree is about to make me cry, y'all, because there's literally nothing. We have to get up out of here immediately.
That Dollar Tree was so bad. It was so bad, like clear down, like there was nothing of substance in there. I had to get out there immediately. I just left my cart and I walked out because, girl, there was nothing. Oh, the light's over here. So yeah, we're gonna have to try to go somewhere else. This is what I get for waiting until the last minute. So I love that for me. I just left Dollar General. We had better luck in there, not too much, because you know that's what happens when you wait for the last minute. Like, literally all the shelves were cleared. There was nothing on theme, but you gotta work with what you're given. So now we're on our way back home. I have to stop by our Amazon locker so I can pick up the two packages that came in. They're basically just the things I got for the boys' Valentine's Day baskets. So I'm gonna pick those up and then we're going to head home and make the baskets. So I'll catch you guys when we are home. Okay, we're home. Let's get this basket together. Okay, this is Case. I love how it turned out. I got this from Amazon, this book from Walmart. Good morning, it's Wednesday and I have the flu. Last night was literally the worst. I had the worst symptoms ever. I had body aches, I had body chills, I had a fever. And I have this raging headache that will not go away. Like, literally so much pressure in the front of my head. Like, I could not look at a screen. I laid in a dark room after making the Valentine's Day basket because it hurt so much just to look at my phone, just to look at the TV. Like, I really needed to just lay down and rest. Thankfully, like, my boyfriend just took Kay and was keeping him entertained because it was just really bad. I was indeed losing my mind. I never like got hit so bad like with the flu. I don't think I ever had a flu. Like, this is my first experience having a flu and it's not fun. I do not recommend. After making the baskets, I got no reaction from Kay. He can care less about the basket, honestly. So that was fun in itself. But I feel like that's just a tradition like I want to start doing with him. I always remember from my childhood, my mom would like give us little things here and there on Valentine's Day. Like, she did what she can to make the day special. So I really just want to carry on that tradition. I feel like we heal like our inner child by doing stuff for our kids. So that's just something I wanted to incorporate into one of our traditions. Today I'm just gonna be resting. I might not vlog as much, but I got some PR packages in yesterday, so maybe we can unbox that together a little later. But for now, I'm just gonna chill because I do feel a little better, but my head is still kind of killing me. That's really the update I wanted to give y'all. Hot wings and fries for brekkie? Is this contributing to the reason why my body is shutting down? Possibly. But fuck it, we ball. Hey girl, it's 5 and I'm filing me up. I took a shower. I did some things in Kay's room, like pick up his toys, restocked his diapers and his wipes. I forgot to film that because I was just so in the zone. I had the music on blast listening to The Weeknd. You know, he got me in my zone. So I figured I'll pick up the camera while we pick up the kitchen because I'm still debating on whether or not I should do dinner tonight. I probably am since I haven't been cooking for the past 2 days. Because I was out sick down in the dumps. But at least let's load these dishes in the dishwasher and unload the dishwasher and put those dishes away. So let's do that together. Normally I'm quick to switch up my plan. Can I have a brown sugar oat milk shaken espresso, a tall?
A tall?
Yes. Can you add 2 pumps of liquid sugar and like a pump of French vanilla?
You want, we don't have French vanilla. Our French vanilla is hazelnut and vanilla.
Okay, that's fine.
Is that okay? And you
yes.
want one of each of those?
Yes.
And you said one liquid cake, right?
Two, please.
Oh, two. I'm sorry.
It's okay. You guys have potato, cheddar, and chive bakes?
We actually, our location does not have it. We actually, our location just wants
it. So then can I just get the bacon and Gruyere egg bites?
Absolutely. Anything else?
No, that'll be all.
All right, 11:35.
Thank you.
Yep.
Ah, she's the perfect color. Hey girl, it's Saturday. Good morning, team. We are out the house bright and early. It is 9 o'clock on the dot because we are having a maintenance day. We're gonna get a blowout on this hair. We're gonna get our nails did because it's date night and also I deserve it. I've had too many mental breakdowns this week, so we gotta revive ourselves in some way. I stopped by Starbucks for treats as well because I know I'm gonna be up in the salon for a long time, a super long time. They open at 8, so it's 9 now. I'm assuming to be here till maybe 12 because my hair, I already know her. She's gonna take a while. Hold on, girl, because a bus is coming and I really think I'm in its spot. Like, I can't find no type of parking here. And it's really making me feel some type of way, if I'm being very honest with you. I'm back. I finally found a parking space. It's snowing and it's giving winter wonderland, which really confuses me because didn't the groundhog pop his head up and said we're supposed to have an early spring? This is spring? I'm confused. And this is why we shouldn't rely on mammals to predict our weathers for us, because how did that even come about? Like, that really confused me. What's his name? Puxatans? I don't know, but he got some questions to answer. I don't know, girl, but let's go ahead and start this maintenance day because mama needs it. She really does. I need to feel like a brand new person. I'm probably gonna cut my hair. I've really been debating on it on the drive over here, but I don't know if that's like my existential crisis talking or what. But we're about to find out. First of all, who is she? I love her. I got layers. I didn't decide to, chop all my hair off like I was saying, but I just got layers and I love how she looks. Like, God bless my Dominican sisters because they be knowing what they be doing, okay? And they never miss at all. So I was a little nervous while she was cutting my hair because she was doing it in like all different angles. I was like, God help me, because I thought I was gonna come out there looking crazy, but she actually looks really good and it looks better from the back. Like the layers, you could see them more like defined and just amazing. So I feel great. Stop number one is completed. Hair is laid. So let's go and get these nubs done. I just have one thing to say. And that is that she ate down. Okay, I tried out a new shape and I absolutely love it. I went with almond French tips and girl, let me tell you, I feel great. I feel like I'm thriving. I definitely needed this morning desperately, like, hello? Hold on. Hello, don't play with me. Yes, okay, yes, we're having such a good day. We're gonna stop by the mall because I need to try to find something to wear for tonight. For date night, we're gonna do a little sip and paint and make candles. So I'm so excited. and I can't stop showing off my nails. I really cannot stop. The hair was laid, the nails eat. Okay? All right, let's go by the mall, and then I'm gonna get my boyfriend some Chipotle because I feel like he's been starving all morning, and I gotta pay back some rewards since daddy paid for my nails, so let's go.
I don't know why I went to Aeropostale. I should have just came to American Eagle instead. I found some jeans. They're a size 14, but why are they so insane? I don't know. But I'm getting hot and I can't continue to put on the stuff before I sweat my hair out. I found a much better contender and they actually fit. They're just a little like loose in the back, but I guess that's the best that I'm gonna get for now.
Okay girls, so I just finished getting ready. This is what the face is looking like. Let me show you the outfit really quick because I love how it came together. You think that's fun? All right, so this is the fit. I found this, I guess it's like a cardigan or a jacket in the 70% off section at American Eagle when I was there. So of course I snagged it, it was like $10. And then look how the jeans fit. I ended up getting the ones that fit me a little better. Don't they look so good? Yes. It's giving casual, it's giving Picasso vibes, okay? Since we're gonna be painting and making our candles, so. Yeah, this is the fit, y'all. And I did a little light beat, just some concealer, did my eyebrows, and put some lashes on. So, yeah. This is our inspiration for the night. That's what we're gonna be painting right there. So, she looks very complex. Okay, I'm a bit scared, but let's see what she turns out with. This is the before. We got our wine for the little sippy sips and our cup. My man went out to get me some water before, you know, I hyperventilate and die, so. Let's see how this goes.
Intended.
Picasso, I like it.
Don't even bother looking at it.
This is Picasso. This is his side.
No pun intended, yeah.
This is his side.
They gonna like my side.
Hers and his and hers.
Mine is rugged.
Please comment which side you like better. He's saying y'all like his side better, but I don't know.
Mine got substance. Yours naked.
Yours. Hi guys, we're home now from our date night and we had so much fun and we definitely needed that. I needed to get dressed up, put my makeup on, and just have a good time. Like, that is really important to schedule out time like with your partner, because when you're raising a kid, it really can all turn into about them and you lose sight of each other. You just like keep pushing things off that you do for each other. So we want to make it more of an effort to do stuff for one another. So yeah, and just like spend time together. So that was so much fun. So we made candles. This is my boyfriend's. It says relax and unwind, and mine says best mom ever. Duh. And then we have our canvases here. I am going to go ahead and end the vlog here. Thank you guys so much for watching and tuning in to this weekly vlog. And I'll catch you guys in the next one, okay? Bye. Oh, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Duh. Okay, now, seriously, bye.